From the Vice Presidential Bet, Lito Atienza lambasts the COMELEC after he encountered issues with the agency's online precinct finder. The House Deputy Speaker and three-time Manila Mayor said he had his staff check his voter status using the website, only to find out his name is missing in the polling precinct in Manila. Atienza believes this could be a move to disenfranchise voters and cheat in the upcoming elections.
Lumalabas, hindi ako rehistrado ron. Ito po hindi bagong pandaraya. Luma na ito sa kasaysayan ng mga mandarambong sa politika.
Atienza adds he wants the matter investigated.
Another daughter of the Philippine Vice President asks the National Bureau of Investigation to trace the creators of malicious online posts against her. A lawyer for Dr. Trisha Robredo wrote to the NBI Cybercrime Division and listed the possible cybercrimes targeting her. Dr. Robredo's sister, Aika, had asked the NBI last week to probe websites which uploaded fake lewd videos that purportedly featured her. The NBI has already identified some of the administrators who created the malicious posts against Aika. The Bureau says it will send them letters to take down the posts.
An official of a local volunteer group backing the presidential bid of Vice President Lenny Robredo has gone missing in Quezon Province. Dante Gatdula, the head of the Robredo People's Council in Candelaria, has been gone for 4 days. His family says Gatdula was on his way to Lucena last Saturday to meet with fellow Robredo supporters to discuss details of a campaign rally scheduled this week, but he never came home and has yet to make contact with anyone. It is still unclear whether Gatdula's disappearance is politically motivated. Police in the Calabarzon region have been notified of Gatdula's disappearance.
More areas are placed under COMELEC control less than 2 weeks before the election. The full body placed Marawi City and 7 other municipalities in Mindanao under its watch upon the recommendation of the police and the military. Marawi was ground zero of the 5-month-long battle between government forces and the ISIS-linked Maute group back in 2017. The towns of Tubaran and Malabang in Lanao del Sur were also placed under COMELEC control last week. Over 100 other places have meanwhile been identified as areas of concern amid the threat of election-related violence.
The so-called Kusi wing of the Philippines' ruling party PDP-Laban to join forces with the uni team of Presidential Bet Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos and his running mate, Sara Duterte. PDP-Laban released a poster hinting President Duterte could join their campaign sorties. The president has yet to name his preferred successor, but he has endorsed 17 senatorial candidates, most of whom are from the PDP-Laban Kusi wing and the uni team. The PDP-Laban Kusi wing has endorsed Marcos for the presidency and adopted Duterte's daughter as their vice presidential candidate.
Progressive Coalition Makabayan unveils a list of 10 more senatorial candidates it will support in the May 9 elections. These are former Ifugao Representative Ted V. Gawilat, former Vice President Jejomar Binay, Senator Laila De Lima, Human Rights Defender Attorney Shel Jocno, Sorsogon Governor Chis Escudero, Attorney Luke Espiritu, Senator Risa Hontiveros, Attorney Alex Lacson, Antique Representative Loren Legarda, and Labor Leader Sonny Matula. The list is on top of 2 senatorial bets they previously endorsed, Neri Colmenares and Bong Labog. Makabayan President Saturo Campos says these candidates share a common stand with the coalition on various issues.
We have been relating with them for a long time on various issues, on the struggles against the Marcos dictatorship in the earlier period, then during the Bacapagal Arroyo government that we had to work with us because the Arroyo government tried to repress our party system.
Ocampo has this to say about those critical of their lineup for including candidates who have already been part of the system the group is trying to reform.
Philippine politics is not moving on a straight line. and politicians tend to be pragmatic in certain instances, but there are basic principles, there are basic issues on which the Makabayan has been consistently advocating, with which they concur with us. We are not looking after people who are completely thinking along with us, but who share only certain portions of our advocacies, strong enough to consider them as possible allies should they be elected to the Senate.
Here's our Tuesday brief on the campaign trail. Former Senator Bongbong Marcos held a press briefing for the first time since the campaign period began. Marcos spoke in Cagayan de Oro about his plans to boost cooperation between the government and the private sector to help pandemic hit small businesses. Marcos also shared in an interview with CNN Philippines that he may not need a spokesperson if he wins the presidency, saying he can face the media himself. His statement comes amid criticisms he evades interviews and debates. Vice President Lenny Robredo pledged support for fishermen, farmers, and other sectors during a visit to Occidental Mindoro. Robredo was supposed to join a campaign rally of Cebu gubernatorial candidate Ace Durano in Talisay City, but her appearance was canceled after Durano said his party decided to endorse Marcos. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno visited Panay Island. He received a warm welcome from Aklan residents, even as some local officials in the province are supporting other candidates. Moreno is optimistic he could still pull a surprise victory in the May 9 elections.
Philippine police arrest several suspects allegedly behind a breach in the automated system of the Election Commission's technology contractor, Smartmatic. The three suspects were arrested in two separate sting operations in Cavite and Laguna after two of them asked for a 10 million peso down payment for their services. Authorities say the suspects are connected to a former Smartmatic employee who is already being investigated for a security breach at the firm.
Naghanap sila ng mga kandidato na sumasang-ayon sa kanilang mga plano na mag-hack at papanalunin. Ayaw namin manggitin ang mga pangalan at probinsya. Na-file na namin ang kaso na system interference, illegal access, at saka yung attempt in the commission of cybercrime.
In a Senate hearing in January, the Philippine National Police's Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center told lawmakers that Smartmatic system had been compromised. Comelec Commissioner Marlon Casquejo, however, insisted during that same hearing the breach will not have an effect on the May 9 elections since the hackers did not access pertinent information.
The Philippine Election Commission sets strict controls on its planned panel interviews of presidential and vice presidential bids. The poll body says the choice of panel members and their questions will need its approval. Comelec Commissioner George Garcia says their partnership with the country's Association of Broadcasters may be finalized by Wednesday. Garcia also responded to doubts raised by VP Bet Walden Belio over the poll body's competence in organizing debates and the elections in general.
Pag-hold po ng debate ay different matter sa pag-hold ng eleksyon. Wala naman po may kagustuhan dito sa pangyayaring ito. Siyempre po, ito ay kahit paano dumis, kahit ganong kaliit sa integridad po ng Commission ng Eleksyon. At kami nga po ay humihingi talaga ng paumanhin sa nangyari.
Local absentee voting in the Philippines set to begin today, Wednesday. Comelec data shows over 84,000 have signed up for the three-day absentee voting. The LAV is for uniformed personnel and members of the media who will report to work on election day. Ballots for the absentee voting will be canvassed on May 9. Poll Commissioner George Garcia seeks to assure voters that their ballots will be secured. He also urges them not to waste a chance to cast their vote for the election.
Huwag niyo pong ibaliwala itong pagkakataon ito. Ang pakialam natin is dapat makaboto ang lahat ng Pilipino. Ano man ang katayuan niya sa buhay, lalong-lalo na kung siya ay may trabaho.
Social media giant Facebook urged to explain its takedown of posts by several government officials. Senator Bong Revilla wrote to Facebook's country director John Rubio on Tuesday. He cries censorship over the move, citing how this could have implications on the country's security and sovereignty. Revilla also suggests politics could be behind the social media platform's actions. Revilla is the chairman of the Senate Committee on Public Information and Mass Media. Last week, Facebook also warned National Security Advisor Hermógenes Esperón over his post that claimed communist insurgents have infiltrated Congress.
Meanwhile, Facebook restores the account of Attorney Vic Rodriguez, the spokesperson and chief of staff of presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos. Facebook's parent company, Meta, has explained the account was mistakenly restricted for reasons unrelated to any content that Rodriguez posted. Rodriguez has thanked lawmakers and other personalities who stood behind him after Meta suspended his account. He earlier claimed the suspension was due to his support for Marcos and called it censorship to the highest degree.